This is Scott from Eyelash Award. I'm doing the Little Muskegon River in my 15-foot We-No-Nah Saranac. And expect to be about 4 to 5 hours, about 11 miles. Starting here in Altona. And I have Pixie with me today, so we're gonna get started. Welcome. I am standing on the Maple Street Dam in Altona. This Maple Street road that goes across this dam has been closed for some time. I don't know how long. It's in pretty bad shape. And I am looking upriver here. I'll be paddling downriver from this point to Morley, with one dam in between, which is the Rusford Dam, and then eventually Morley Pond, where there's the dam at Morley. It's about a 12-mile paddle. It's a beautiful day. I have my dog, Pixie, and we are going to have a good paddle. I will be dispersing comments throughout the video as I come upon different things as we do our journey here. So in the meantime, enjoy and thank you. Thank you. We are switching to 8x speed here so that I can get the entire paddle in under 1 hour. It'll be closer to 50 minutes. The Little Muskegon River with the low water is quite slow. Somewhere between 2-2.5 mile an hour is about as good as it gets as far as the current. With a little bit of paddling, go a little faster. I do paddle quite a bit, but I do like to float sometimes and just listen to the sounds around me. So that's why my paddles tend to take a little bit longer. Also on this river, with the low water, there's quite a lot of bottom scrubbing and hang-ups. I would say there's at least a dozen to a dozen and a half of those. And a few times you'll see the video cut, and that's just because I might be hung up on something and I just cut that video out. This would be probably a good example of something that was a little shorter, but I didn't decide to cut it out just to kind of give you an idea. But other ones that were maybe a little longer, I cut out. So rather than having you hear all the scraping and the clang, the banging of the paddle on the side of the canoe, I thought I would just throw some background music in here and speed it up. Now, occasionally I do put the video back into real time. Most of the time I add the sound, there's at least one cut that I didn't, just because sound didn't really add anything. And I will likely comment during those real-time cuts. Jennifer and I were two tracking one day, and we were coming in from the left, and we encountered this bridge, and we looked at it from the top view there, and that was maybe 5 years ago, and it looked pretty sketchy. In my estimation here, based on my viewpoint from here and 5 years ago at the bottom, I would say this bridge is still abandoned. I wasn't going across it with my Jeep, let's put it that way. So anyway, I thought it was interesting. I thought I would put the video back to real time and give you a view of this. And maybe you could go across, but I don't think I would do it. Thank you. This is the Rustford Dam. And I found a little shoot off to the right here. I did see this on the Gaia GPS map. I didn't really know. I didn't know what was going to be here, but I could see that there was a tree down. If I would have kept going, there would be a similar drop like you would see on the left. But then there was this takeout. So I wasn't going to be able to go past this tree anyway. But as I approached this, the tree, I could see there was a takeout there, and that's what I took advantage of. Now this area, I didn't see any signs as I'm going on the takeout that said private property. I do know that I'm walking across a cut lawn. On the map, it's marked DNR. But if you look at the road, there's a sign there that does say private property. I'm just not sure if people tend to put the sign in a way that it makes it look like you can't pass through the road that goes to the object or to the property. They sometimes face it that way when they're really marking the property just to deter people from driving down the road. I don't know if that was the case here, if I'm actually walking. I don't know if I'm walking on private property right now, if this is part of the DNR. The DNR piece. I mean, this could have been sold by the DNR to, you know, as private property. I don't know. Where I commented earlier about that tree and taking out there, this is would be the other end of that, and I'm pretty sure there's a drop there with a dam that wouldn't have been passable, but I don't know. I didn't get beyond that tree, but this would be the outlet here that I'm videoing there. My wife Jennifer and I have always been attracted to this house that is on the other side of this bridge here, off to the right. It's an old, very old house. You can kind of see it there. And it just, in my head, it's like I think about how that must have been like back in the day when that house was being used, and how they used the river and how they farmed the land. Just fascinating to me. in one of my mini stops, just making sure the GoPro camera was working. I must have forgot to press record. So there's a small section of the river that I missed that happened to have the 155th Avenue Bridge. So I did miss going under that bridge. As I was paddling this section of the river, there were three people in the river that were waiting, having their photograph taken, and there was one person up on shore that was taking the photograph, and I was sort of kind of gonna try to photobomb their photo, but they did see me, and they wanted me in the picture, but I wasn't able to really stop easily, and it was kind of shallow there. I mean, I could have, but well, anyway, I didn't end up stopping, but it was fun.
I'm gonna... Ow! Okay, sorry, I can't stop.
When I got past the halfway point of the paddling for the day, I did start to see a lot of fish. Smallmouth bass, I believe some suckers, definitely some trout, a pike here and there. You can see them in this video here, and then I do stop on a real time in another part of the video to show you some additional fish. But you know, from this point forward, there was just a lot of that. This river seems healthy, and I do have a co-worker that had pointed out that the Little Muskegon does do a nice smallmouth bass fishing offering, so something to think about. And here's another section of the river where there's a good example of some fish that you can see. Just seem to be like this from this part of the river all the way into Morley Pond.
Good, how are you?
Not too bad.
Good. Lots of fishing down here?
Yep.
So many bass up there.
Yeah, I caught a few smallmouth up here.
Yeah, yeah, there. Lots and lots of suckers with smallmouth.
Yeah, I think I'll keep perch too.
Okay, yeah, very cool.
Have a good rest of the day.
Yeah, hey, thanks, you too.
The paddle was enjoyable. It was nice and peaceful. I scared up about maybe 12 deer along the riverbank that were just laying there. And as maybe they heard a bang on the side of the canoe or something with the paddle, it scared them. And I did see a family of raccoons on the side. I tried to see where I could find that in a video, couldn't locate that. Again, lots of fish, lots of bird. And just a nice paddle. Enjoyed it. It was a little slower than I'm used to, but being by yourself, that's always maybe better. Just so you don't get yourself in trouble as fast. This would be my starting point here. I'll be panning to the right here in just a minute. And that'll be my entry point when I go from Morley down to a bridge down on one of the roads. I think it's Daggett Road Bridge, and that will be my next section that I do on this river. By the way, that building right there was restored some time ago. It was this was used as for a mill site, and the dam failed. They went and fixed it, and then later they rebuilt that, or they fixed that building up. And then this is me coming in to the landing area where my vehicle's parked, and that completes the paddle here. So until next week, take care and thank you.